to home communication. All these things in one online classroom platform, all these things can be possible. Teachers can record, can track student behavior, can facilitate classroom activities, curate student portfolios, and engage in school to home communication. Like that, all these things is being possible in Class Dojo. Okay, for Class Dojo, what first we have to do? You have to go to Google. You have to take the tab, and in Google you have to do Class Dojo. In the first option, https://classdojo.com, you have to click. Then you will be, actually I have started one page, that's why it's coming like this. Otherwise they will be asking you sign up option, like that will be asking to you. Okay, then you have to click Class Dojo, then https://classdojo.com. You have to click, then they will be asking, they'll be going, moving to a page. They will be asking, bring every family into a classroom, sign up, like that option will be there. You have to click sign up option, and there you will be asking sign up as Class Dojo, sign up Class Dojo as a teacher or a parent, student or a school leader. As a teacher, we have to click the option teacher. Okay, if the account is not being created, they will be asking you your surname, Mr. Mrs. like that, they will be asking. Then your first name will be asked. If you click Class Dojo, then will be asking like that. First name will be asked. Then last name, they will be asking your email and password also will be asking. When you click all these things, when you type all these things, they will be asking you to sign up. Okay, when you have created an account in Class Dojo, then we'll be moving on to the first page. There you are able to see the demo class and the plus button with new class. There you have to create the option, you have to click the option new class. There you are able to start a new class. Just like that, in Google Classroom, how we are inviting the students or we are adding the students, in Class Dojo also we are able to add our students. So first we are going to create the class, so we are going to create our new class. You click the plus button. Then first they will be asking you the class name. As I am a class teacher of grade 6, I am clicking here grade 6. And sorry, class name 6A, grade 6A, like that I'm clicking. So then they will be asking the grade. You can add your subject to there, grade 6 science, like that. Then you can select your grade. Then they will be asking sharing points, like that. They share only positive points with parents, like that. Then you can create the class. So the class is being created. Then next you have to do, you have to go add students option. Okay. Till now it's clear. First we have to take Class Dojo in the Google, then you have to click https Class Dojo, then the room will be open for you. You have to sign up, then they will be asked, we have to sign up as a class teacher. Then they will be asking you first name, last name, then mail ID, password, everything will be asked. Then you will be able to sign up. When you go to the first page or the home page, they will be having two options, that you have to create a new class. Then that is the press button. When you click, you are able to create a new class. You have first, when you click that one, they will be asking you the class name, and also they will be asking the grade, everything is set. Then you are able to add students. Okay, so first we have to add students. Then for adding, they'll be asking the name of the student. Okay, like that plus button you can click. Then we'll be, we have to use the last name also. first student has been saved, you can save option. Thing is that there are options. Okay, there's a class in the class. One student is being added. There are options like that we are able to copy it from. Okay, that we can copy the students also. Every time you know need to add each student. Here the option is there, copy and paste to a student list. Then when you click that, you have already be saved your teacher student's number, student's name. You can copy the students' names from there and you can paste it here. Okay, like that you are able to create the class. So the class I have already created one class. So the class 6 science, 4 students, I have created one class. Okay, these were the students I am having. Then what you have to do it, what are the features that we can do in it? We are able to evaluate our children. Okay, evaluate our students, we can give points to our children, and also we can include more and more activities to the children in this, just like how we are able to do in the Google Classroom. We'll be assigning, we'll be giving assignments, we'll be giving activities like that. In Class Dojo also, we are able to give activities, and we are able to give videos. All these things is possible in Class Dojo. Okay, we have already created students. Okay, we have added students in our class. Then if you want, okay, we are able to make the students into group also. For that, you click group. Okay, then they will be asking you add group. Already I have made one group. If you find which are the students, we have to group in one group A. For example, we are having LA students, MA, HA students, like that. If you want to give activities on the basis, on that basis, we can group the students accordingly. Okay, we can, and also we can group A, group B, group C, like that you are able to group the students. Okay. Yes, I am making a group. Okay, new group like that, and I'm able to name the group also, or you can number the group also. Like that you are able to give group 3 like that. Then you can click create group. Yes, the group is being created. Yes, one, I'm having 3 groups here, 1, 2, 3, like that I have created the groups. And some other things we can, more features we can do in this. We are even click students, we are able to give them points. Okay, we will know we are all of our students having each of our students is having good qualities, like helping others, participating actively, participating when you are giving a work as a group or as individually, they will be performing well. Like that, if we are doing, we are able to give points in that point. Okay, if they are doing something good, okay, they are helping others. Yes, if you want to give point to that particular student, we are able to give. So first my student is Devaki. I want to give her, she has helped her friends, that's why we have to give points. Then you click yes, we are able to give Devaki 1 point for helping others. And thing is that these are the some of the qualities they are having. If you want to give another quality, or we have to add another quality, we are having the option edit skills. In that edit skill, when you click add skill, then for they are using the chat box perfectly. So, or they are completing the assignment on time. We are doing like that. Yes. Assignment on time, like that we are able to add new skill. So we are able to give points according here. What we can other points we are already being built, but this here we are able to give points according to our wish. We have to give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Maximum 5 points, like that we are able to give putting assignment on time, then we'll have give 5 points. And also, they are having different pictures according to which we are able to choose this on time. They are keeping. So I'm keeping this clock picture there for that particular skill. Yes, then we can save. Yes, my skill is being added. Assignment on time like that. So like that, any skill or any of their positive skill we are able to add here. And here you are able, this is the positive ones. Here you are able to see the needs work. Here this is that actually, yes, we are able to add skill. Yes, negative points also we are able to give. Okay, if you are doing some, they are late on class or like that, if you want, that is up to us. If you want to give negative points also, we are able to give here the point weight, then negative, minus one, minus two, like that here. I don't want to give my students, all my students are good, so I don't want to give them negative points. We have to, there are option is there if you want to give them negative points, that's it. So I have given the point that is been added. Like that, you are able to, any activity they are performing, any good things they are performing, we are able to give points to them. Hope till now it's clear.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So we have added students here. We are able to group students here. Like that, we are done. Okay, we are having three groups here, and when we giving points or we are, thing is that we are individually we are able to give student points as a group. When they are doing some work, they are completing there also we are able to give them points. That's our group. Then many skills are there, we according to which one or teamwork we have hand to deal both. Yes. At that time, the point will be given to all the students who are in that particular group. If you want to give points to the group one, the group, students who are in group one will get the points. And student, if you want to give points to the group two, the students who are in group two will be getting all these points. We didn't give points to group three, so okay, we'll be giving. Yes. So here all the groups got point. Okay, well, group one, group two, group three, all got points. Okay, like that we are. And also here we are able to give, when you award group, we are able to post also. Yes, good work. Like that, extra points, extra appreciation we have to give also, that possible. Yes. You have to click add post. The thing is that we are able to write here also. If you want to add any photos or files or like that also, it is possible for us to give. Yeah, appreciation also we are able to give, and we are have to give some activities that from that here, the file when you click, that we can draw files for that particular group. That is also possible from browse. Like that you can take any assignments or any activities or like that we are able to post there also. So click post, then it will be get posted like that. We are able to give feedbacks. Then we will be moving to other options. That is about the classroom. We are able to add students here. We are able to group the students who are being added here, that all things are possible. Okay. Okay, then comes these are the things about the classroom. Then we'll be moving on to next option, portfolios. Yes, we are able to see this page. Here we are able to give students the activities. Okay, activities, some assignments, or we want to give some circular, everything is possible here in this portfolio. You're able to see some of the students is having some comments. Okay, when we discussed the classroom, we are able to add post. That post will be displayed here. I have given in that add post, I had given the command hard working, good work. Good work is being given to the group. So both Durga, that both the students in group 2 is able to get that post, that good positive post will be there, good work like that, two students is having, that's why. And thing is that along with that, the group student is along getting that some post, that will also be displayed here. All these things we are doing, it will be displayed in their portfolios. So create first, if you want to give some activity assignments, or we have want to post some circular, everything is possible in this create act here, that we have to click create activity. Okay, so if you want to give one worksheet, so here we can do the instruction. Here we are having a response type here. Here, if you want it text like that, or they want to make a video on a particular topic, or where they want to take the photos and post it like that, we are able to. Okay, yes. For example, when we are having Hiroshima Day, yes, we have celebrated Hiroshima Day. Like that, we have done our. We have celebrated post office day like that. On that day, each student has made different posters. They have made videos like that. They have done. So what we can do is, yes, we can give the title post office day. If you want photos, then you can click photo option. Or if you want video, then we can click video options. If you want drawings from them, we can click drawing option. And thing is that here we are having options. That whole class has been will be able to give that activity for the whole class. If you want to give a particular activity to a particular student, that is also possible. So for example, for one student we want a drawing, and if you want photo like that, you can click. So here what we are able to give each student, we'll be able to know each student is having what are the capabilities. So according on this basis, we are able to give them works. We are able to give them works. If you want to take the photo, if their student is very perfect in doing the videos, then we can give that activity. They are doing the drawing and all this perfectly, we can give it drawing to them. They are write article on them, we can click text and give that particular student that activity. And group activity is also possible, and also individual activities also possible here, and also whole class also we can assign that particular activity. Then you can do assign to the class. We are able to assign to the individually as well as for the whole class. And here you are able to see one record option. So record option is also available. If you want to say something, a dear student, please make poster for that particular class, for the particular topic, then we are able to record the video also. So if it's possible for us to record video, I think because my net is little less, I think, one second. So here we will be getting the option that here we are able to record our videos and post it for the particular student, and also for the group, and also we will be able to assign it for the whole students also. Here the record option we will be getting. Like that, you are able to create activities here. And if you want, for example, for particular student also, we will be able to, when you click after giving the activity, how we are able to give the activity to the student, that I will tell you. After giving the activity, when you click each student, they will be able to see their submissions. Okay, we will be able to give the see their pictures, videos, drawings like that. You have to click each student. Then it will be displayed here. That's they like that portfolios will be displayed here. We'll be able to evaluate it. Like that, these are the things we are able to get. These are the options we'll be getting in the portfolio. So that's about the portfolios. Okay. Then comes to the next option feature they are having, that is the class to read. It is just like the Google Classroom. We are able to give circular. We are able to post via activities like that here in here also. Then we can record it. We can file it. We can upload files. We are able to give photos and videos here. And also we are able to record here. And if an event, for example, an event is upcoming on 20th or next week. For example, we are conducting Art First, or we are conducting Oxfos like that. We are able to create an event there. So for example, I'm here typing Oxfos. Arts Festival also. Arts Day. So here you are having then we click, then it is from 22nd, okay, 22nd to 25th, like that you are able to create that event. It is for all day. We can click the all day option, that's from 22nd to 25th you are having, okay. Please join like that. You can give descriptions also. If you want to change the theme, you can change the theme. It's just a reminder. Immediately we want to post, then we can post it immediately also. Like that you have created it, okay. You can create, you can post here. Yes, Arts Day is there. Okay, actually, thing is that we are able to, here also we are able to record if you want to say share something with the class, we are able to record also. I have already recorded and post it here.
Students, good morning.
Like that we are able to post it, record. We can record our what we have to convey with the students. We can record it, or for the parents, or like that we are able to record it and we can post it here. These were the some of the features we are having in this class story. Okay. Till now it's clear. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. It's all clear. Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. So we have discussed about classroom. We have discussed about portfolios, class stories also. Then we are having some other options also here. We are able to put attendance. So we are according to the I'm putting here. Yes, the one student is absent. So we are putting absent, and others is present. Okay, then we can save attendance. Okay, if you want to see how many students are absent on a particular day, we are to click the options here. Okay, after invite next to invite families, we are having the options here. We view reports you can take. So here we are able to see the attendance. Yes, yes, the attendance is marked here. All present, no attendance, one student is absent, that like that we are able to see. If you want to see one student, particular student attendance, that is also possible. Yes, when you click the name, we are able to, particular student's attendance also, we are able to see there in the view reports, the attendance will be displayed there, like that it's 100%, like that it will be there. If it can be done for a week, last week also, thing is that we can clicking this week like that, we are able to see the last week's attendance also, we are able to see like that. Attendance can also can be marked here. It is very easy also. Thing is that the absent is like that will be displayed. We will be able to put the attendance too. Okay. And next thing is how our students will be able to see their assignments and what the teacher has said to them, how the students will be able to log in. Okay. So here we are having the option student login. Okay. Thing is that if a student has to log in, they say have to simply click the Class Dojo. Then they will be asking how they have to sign up. There they have to click the student option. Okay. So thing is that we are giving activities. then the activities we can give in the classroom, as well as we are able to give activities they can do from home. If you are giving activities that you have to give activities in the classroom, what we have to do is we have to classroom login will be there. There they will be usually we will be having three options. They will be asking you choose scan the QR code and enter, like that options they will be getting. They will be asking class text code, like that they will be asking, or they can sign in with the Google. Three options will be there for them. It is better we can choose class code, that will be more easy for the students. They can, students can open Class Dojo website and they can click sign up as student. Then they will be asking the code, they can put this code and they can enter the class and they can do the activities and they can submit their activities. That is when we are doing it live in the class, we are doing the activity. If you are doing it for home, in the home, so they can, we are having options so that we can share the activity. Then we'll be clicking share, then we'll be get a link. We have to copy the link. We can send that link to their parents. With the help of the parents, they will be able to they will be able to present their activity in this Class Dojo. Okay. And another feature we are having is in the class, we will be having monsters here for each of the student. If you want to change monsters, we want to, they do, if sometimes they will be saying in the class, ma'am, the monster we are giving is not good, I want to change the monster, it is possible. We are able to change the monster also. We'll be able to choose any of the monsters according to the wish also. We'll be able to choose like that. Okay, yes, then done. Then we are able to change like that. And in Class Dojo, we are students login as well as parents also able to see their activities. For that, we have to invite the parents to our Class Dojo. Okay. Then we invite families option, we can click. We are able to see the students here. We have see parents of different students here. Devagi, Dugga, Paru, like that. Parents, we are able to invite. We can invite the parents through mail also, through phone also, we are able to invite. So we have to give the student, we have to, there we have to place the parents of mail ID or phone number, through that we are able to invite. They will be able to see activities, everything will be able to see through this Class Dojo. So we have to give the parent mail ID. Then we have to, or we can use the phone number also, then we can invite the parents. Then teacher, student, they will be able to see their children's activities, whatever the points they get, like that they are able to see. And thing is that we can add co-teachers also here. In the Class Dojo, we can enter other teachers. Those teachers we want to add, we can add teachers' mail IDs here. We are able to invite other teachers to the class and we can share the class like that possible. So we are here, we are having options. Parents can comment, other co-teachers can, then like that we are able to, if you want to off it, we are able to off it, like that it is possible. Like that we can do. So skills we have discussed, families, students. And if you want, in between we want to add students, it is possible that we can add students like that. If you want to remove the students, that is also possible, possible here. Okay. And we are, one of the important thing is that we can group it. Thing is that according to their we know our students, okay, then we can group students on their skills. They we can group them, group one like that, group two, and we can assign the activities to that particular group also. It's possible here. Then it will be easy for us when we are giving worksheets or we are giving activities like that. We are able to give the activity to the group, that students, and we can point. Thing is that when they see their points, they will also will be become very happy. That's much of points I have got. Yes, this much teacher has assessed me in this my quality, helping others, or maybe active in the chat box, using the chat box perfectly, or they are completing the assignments, they are completing their task on time, like that. They will be get very happy. They will be very happy when they get appreciated. All is like appreciation. So we are giving the points that will be more attractive for them. In the Google Classroom, we are not able. We are giving marks and all, but they are not. We are not giving. We are not able to give the points. Thing is that we are giving the point for a particular thing they have done, or maybe for hard work they are participating well, punctuality, like that. We will be giving the points, so the students will be happy and they will be able to see their activities. Thing is that they can maximum utilize that points. Thing is that it will motivate them more. When we are giving good points, they will be motivated more and they will doing things. Yes, I got that point for that particular thing, like that. They will be more happy also. So that is the class dojo. Thing is that we can give activities, we can communicate to the parents, we are able to share their thoughts, children's thoughts, and we can post videos also. We can record the videos and we can post it. We can upload any files from our worksheets, everything to there, and we can give activities based on their skills. If they are having drawing skill, we can give activity on that basis. If we are having they are able to write like that, we can on that basis we are able to give, or we can group the students like that. It is possible in Class Dojo. It's a very good tool. Thing is that we can do, first we have to create the classroom, that's the first thing, and we can invite the parents also there. They can also able to view their students points, their children's point, what which are the areas they are getting the points. If you are adding negative, they can improve themselves also, improve the students. They are not hardworking. We can do more. Punctuality is not there. We can do negative points also. The thing is possible. That's the we are able to evaluate our children, and also portfolio is also possible. They can keep their all the thing is that all the thing is being saved there. When you click each student, their activities will be displayed. What are the things they have done in that particular period? That is possible, because we are, when you click this view reports, we are able to see all the activities. Here we are able to see that that party work, assignment on time, like that. We are able to see each activities also, what are the positive things, their points they got, need work, like that. We are able to see. And thing is that here where we are having the option views spreadsheet, we are able to download it also. Thing if you want to print, that is also possible, that a particular student's activity, everything will be able to see that activities. Yes, here you are able to see the teacher, they have got the skills, working hard, teamwork, assignment, like that, how much points they got, how it is individual or it is group, like that. Also we are able to see the report also in here, how much points they got for each activity, like that. It is possible. And thing is that we are able to add more points here. That is one of the feature. Add more skills according to their activity they are doing and how they are performing. We are able to give more activities also. We are able to give. And if you, as a teacher, if you want to do some more things with messaging, or we can change password, that is all this also possible here. If you can give a comment, edit class, everything is possible for the teacher also in this message. And also we can give reminders also. For example, in the class story, if you are giving these events, we can, they will be giving reminder options also is possible here. We can give reminders to the students as well as to the parents, and for teachers, student reminder option is also possible. These were the some of the other features of Class Dojo. Any doubts?
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
Madam, I think it's a very useful tool.
Yes,
very
sir.
Good tool. Yeah, thank you so much for the nice presentation. You are crisp and specific. First question is whether it's a paid tool, or how long you can use it if it is a free version.
It is a free version, sir. They are not asking for any payments and all. They are, when I check there in the site, they will be not saying any payment or like that, sir.
Okay. Next question.
Yes,
with which other tool you can compare in terms of its usage?
The thing is that we can compare it with Google Classroom itself, sir.
Correct,
thing is
correct.
That yes,
correct.
Google Classroom. Thing is that, sir, we can more features is there in Class Dojo. There we are not in Google Classroom. We are not able to add points, or we are the values, extra values we are not able to add like that is there. And also when you in the class story, we are able to put videos and also the events. We can add reminders also for there in the class story, sir. So that the reminder will be moving on to the parents as well as teachers will be getting the reminder also.
Yes, ma'am. Wonderful, wonderful. I think it's better than Google Classroom.
Yes, sure, sir. Thing is that more options is there. It is,
yes.
Compared to Google Classroom, it is more simple also, sir.
Correct. And also somewhat interactive. You can, you know, chat option is there. You can,
yes,
give comments for their work. You can appreciate.
Yes, we can add posts, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. And the only thing is whether we want to check whether this saved videos or works, assignments, everything will be remaining there forever, or it will be vanishing, disappearing every month or every week.
Yes, sir. That we
so,
have to.
Please check that feature, whether it can be used for, you know, longer terms and all.
Okay, okay, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. And others, it's open to others for, you know, clearing their doubts.
Yes. Yes, one doubt has been asked by inviting the students. The code will be auto-generated by the website or teacher has to create. It will be auto-generated and that code will last for 48 hours. After that, we have to take another, we have to create another code, ma'am. Shamira, ma'am, it's clear for you?
Aditi, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay, when we invite a parent through a phone, will they get the text message?
No, no. Yes, they will be getting the text message. It is more good if we go through the parent mail ID. That will be more fine, sir, instead of phone. When I check with the, it will be getting is that parents usually not check the text message. So it is better if we having email, then it is more good, sir. Any other queries?
In chat box, there is one query that is there any provision to correct the work of students?
Yes, the thing is that we can comment it, sir. We are able to comment that their work, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Also, you can do corrections, you know, like on the phone, and you can upload, I think. Suppose you have a notebook sent by the student, you can do it on the phone, maybe ticking on the phone or whatever is possible. And also you can upload. Is that upload option is there, ma'am?
Yes, sir, that upload option is there. Thing is that when the students upload their activities, we are able to comment it there, or we can do all these activities, add posts like that option is there, sir.
Okay.
In regards to Google Classroom, what I found is that certain students, they find it so difficult to upload the things. Even after uploading also, it may take a long time to get uploaded. So what about this one?
That I have to check, sir. Thing is that I have, it is a new thing that when students upload it only, we can think. When I try to upload the things and all, it is very easy for me to, did not take much time like that, sir.
Anyway, this is a great tool that, as Salam sir says, it's far better than that Google Classroom, it seems. Thank you for the presentation. It's good.
Actually, you can run a school with this, you know.
Sure, sir. Tool. Sure. Yes, it's very. Yeah, we can do, sir.
Any other questions? Otherwise, we can wind up, ma'am.
It was popular in Gulf country last year itself. By the time I could not go through this, I heard about this and I saw this.
Deepthi ma'am, it was a really nice presentation. Thank you for your effort. Thank you for your presentation. Very brief, to the point. You have done a great work. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Calicut teachers, please not the link. Please not the link questions. Already, Animam has uploaded that. She pasted that in the